Well, sports fans, we're here. It's live. Emperor Goose hunting. We're going after number 5, number 6, number 7, and number 8. Got 4 more hunters this week. They're sitting up. Wind's letting up. Tide's moving. Birds are going to start flying here any minute. Just had one group land up the beach up in Jack Spread, and they're walking around.
Well, Al, what are you thinking here? You're getting ready to start the number?
Absolutely. Great. Day one.
Day one, we just got off the plane, set up, a cold day rain, a little fog, perfect weather. We're going to get haunted in here behind our little brush pile. Hopefully those embers are going to start flying here on the tide.
We had another great day Emperor Goose hunting. I want to thank Alan Carpenter and Forrest for coming up. We had a great time. Alan made a great shot on this, and this is what it's all about, man. I can't thank you enough for coming up and
thank you.
Bringing Forrest out there with you for some moral support and to take some good pictures with us. But anyway, thank you so much, and we're looking forward to the rest of a great trip.
Well, thank you. This has just been awesome so far, and you know, frankly, this is I go to hunting lodges for a living, and this is one of the most comfortable places I've ever been, and especially in a place like this. Just looking outside, seeing the ocean, seeing the views from right here, I didn't expect anything this nice, and I expected it to be pretty nice, but this, you've just blown out of the water, and I can't wait to see what the rest of the week has. I mean, this is just day one, and we've gotten started and already gotten an effort, so that's just awesome. I couldn't be happier. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Forrest. Thank you again, Alan.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thank you.
I just want you to know it was a lot of fun being able to hunt with you two, you know, father and son, because that's what it's all about. It makes me feel good that you guys get to, you know, have a great experience.
Yeah, good. Yeah, this is wonderful. You know, it's something Dad and I have talked about for many, many years. I think probably seriously daydreamt for about 6 years now. And you know, we've always talked about being able to come out and chase emperor geese, you know, just even prior to there being a season, just wanting to go out and see them and do a photo hunt, you know, come out and set up decoys. With Dad living here in Alaska, you know, it's something that we would have been able to do, is just take an airplane out here and come take pictures of something. But when we heard that they were going to open up a season, you know, obviously I got really excited and started, you know, putting in the first year and doing everything I could, but I didn't think about the fact that Dad's a resident and, you know, is able to get all of the perks of just having a tag waiting for him every year. So we went through the process. I've put in for a couple of years and no luck, you know, but at this point, with rumors circulating that there may or may not be seasons after this, it was just one of those things where we just kind of had to pull the trigger, and I just wanted to come out and to be able to watch you take this bird has been so special to me. You know, we just had so much fun hanging out.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock.
Yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Dean, what did you think of that Ember Hunt this morning?
Well, it's not getting blown away. It's as good as it gets.
There you go.
First word, absolutely.
You could be the hero. You get the gold. Breaking all the
records he thought never could. Okay, how'd today go today, Jack?
Pretty solid. 3 for 3 on Emperors. All in all, it was really good.
Well, Dean, what'd you think of the overall hunt?
I can't believe they actually fly in this stuff, but they do.
Well, the flag's right out straight behind you, so it's whipping pretty good.
Yeah. No.
And Lona, I know you had a good time today being the only lady out there being abused.
I did.
You got a beautiful Emperor Goose.
I did. Number one. Thank God a lucky squirrel. You know, a squirrel gets a...
lucky acorn every now and then?
Yeah, a blind squirrel gets a lucky acorn.
How many glasses of wine have you had yet? None. I know.
And she practiced that line all day.
She practiced it all day. And then we got Forrest. Forrest, what'd you think of hunting with your dad?
I loved it. It was awesome. It was everything I came here for, just to get to hang out with him. So
right.
that was pretty
special. Dean, I got to tell you, that was a pretty epic hunt. You know, that first morning, we shook off the cobwebs, and I know we had a little Emperor Goose fever there, but it all worked out in the end, and you made a great shot on the hard bird. I thought you were going to take the easy one, but you said, we're going to give him a chance.
No, I got zeroed in on that one, and I wasn't going to get off that line. I had that one. I wasn't going to let go of it, so it worked out great.
Well, okay. Well, I hope you enjoy a nice fresh halibut dinner here tonight, and keep moving on.
Thank you.
Wind today.
Yeah, not much. Well, we're just getting all honkered in here. Now, for the waiting game. The Emperor Goose waiting game. Wait for him to lift off the roost this morning and come out to the feed on the beach. And hopefully they are going to cooperate. Guys are over on the other side and they are just banging away already. Hopefully they're gonna have some real nice harlequins and maybe a few other mixed bags. A little light breeze starting to pick up, which is just about right. Yeah. Well, if you get a good bright one single, take it. Okay, here comes some straight in on you. Straight in, I can't see him yet.
What do you got to say? You must have to say something.
I got really scared there for a second. But wow, amazing. I mean, unbelievable. It's what I came here for. I mean, to get a bird like that, wow.
Pick that up one more time by the feet. Just lay your gun down there and we'll
put your hand under its belly and kind of just lift straight up. With, yeah, one under the belly and on the feet. That is a big, big mature bird.
Oh, yeah.
Great.
Well, Captain Charlie saying, getting it done again in Cold Bay. Lucian Island Waterfowlers, Team Extreme, rocking them hard, baby. Gotta love it. Congrats. There we go. Okay.
There we go. It's gonna be epic.
It'll be. What do you think, Forrest?
I think it's gonna go great. Can't wait. Got just enough weather out here to keep moving, and not too much where it's just miserable.
Perfect. All right, let's go.
Jump 2020.
Well, sports fans, we're rocking and socking them. Forrest Allen, they got a little bit of everything. They got the Scoter Slam today. They got Harlequin, they got Longtails. It's pretty much, it's been on. They're in the background right there. We're just getting ready to pull the boat for the day. And
Scoter Slam, Harlequin, Old Squaw.
Nice job, man. Anyway, wish everybody a great day out there, and hope to see you soon on another adventure with Captain Charlie, Lucian Island Waterfowlers, rocking it.
Big shout out to Combat Waterfowl in the Fallen Outdoors. Nathan, Elliot, and Matt, they were down here this week. Alan and Forrest just left, but we're still here. We had a big last day. We really went after it for some trophy Aleutian teal. Everybody got some nice Aleutian teal. Finished off with a few Harlequin. Matt, you got a couple real nice Harlequin, and you had some pretty good shooting on that Aleutian teal too.
Yeah, you know, I started out the week a little rough, a little nervous on the Emperor Goose, but closed the deal on that in the first day, and then everything kind of came together as the nerves calmed down, and yeah, got some beautiful birds, and the Aleutian teal was just really set off the end of the trip.
Well, Nathan, what did you think of the trip?
Honestly, probably one of the best trips I've ever been on in my life. I said this was going to be a once-in-a-lifetime trip for me. It's going to be more than that. I'm definitely coming back to Cold Bay.
Then Elliot, I know you've had your heart set on this trip for a while. You know, we had some good weather, we had some bad weather. Today we got a little bit blown off, but you know, that's the thing. What'd you think of the overall trip for what we had to deal with?
Started off great, came out, went out and explored the island. Sunday I was able to get the one duck I came here to shoot, and that was my prize harpoon. It's going on the wall as soon as I get back. Expected it to be a lot colder. Didn't really know what I was walking into. We had a lot of blue days, sunny, no wind. I ended up shooting a couple of Aleutian teal, which I did not expect to shoot on this trip. And I can't thank Charlie and Jack enough for being able to put us on some of these teal. It was once in a lifetime opportunity, and I've already talked with the old lady. It looks like we might be coming back to do a cast and blast because she really wants to catch some big fish, learn how to fly fish with Charlie here. So thanks again for all that you have done. Big shout out real quick, three custom calls from Rob Lund Custom Calls. That meat whistler that we got now, provided by Combat Waterfowl, really put the spell on those Aleutian teal. They liked it, they came in, they decoded perfect, and we put some on the ground. Thanks again, Rob, appreciate everything you've done for us.
And I'd just like to close off by saying, you know, this was the last day. We were being pretty selective. We were pretty much limited out on a lot of the birds. So, you know, and this week we had some guys had a really good week. Some week it was, some people a little bit tougher, but we ended up getting 9 or 10 species all together. We got empers, we got teal, we got scoters, we got white wings, common, serfs, Aleutian teal, we got a bluebill, we got Megansers, we got, what else did we get?
Oh, huge shout out to Nate, the Merg Madness Murderer.
We got it done over at Firefight Point, and that's what I'm talking about. You know, it's everybody, it's about coming up here and having fun. This isn't, it's not just the killing, it's about having a good time, camaraderie with friends, seeing some cool scenery. I mean, we saw bears out there at the point that day. You guys had bears 2 or 3 days. And everybody got a little bit of that action. We've seen some ptarmigan. And but anyway, cheers to everybody out there in TV world. And thanks for watching. We'll see you on another adventure soon.